Yo, this is part two of the last video I recorded of how to photobash. This video is going to be going over jeans and hoodies and how to make them. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so this first section is going to be about the pants. So first thing you're going to want to do to begin with making the pants is grab this part right here. I can't remember exactly what it's called, but you're going to want to grab this part. Or this part right here. Go on, copy it over to your template. Somewhere's around like right here. Don't resize it completely down to like that. Make sure it's up a little bit so you can save some of the quality and copy it. You can either go like this, or for some variation, I'll just copy it like that sometimes. And delete any excess. So like that. And now I'm gonna clone these together so it looks smoother real quick. There we go. Now, what we're gonna do now is increase the hardness of our erase tool a little bit and just erase right under where the white part is. Now, we can just copy this over to this side. There we go. Now we're gonna go back over to the jeans and we're gonna grab this part, the button. We're gonna go up a layer, put it down, and put it like right where the button is on the actual jeans. You're gonna grab the extra part that's off of the jean. You're gonna drag it over to this side and boom. Now erase anything around the button. So like this. And there you go. That's the button done. You can merge that layer down. Now with the fly, we're actually gonna do one more thing though, is grab this little part right next to the button. Go up a layer. And there you go. Put it right there next to the button. And erase this part. And erase this part. So there you go. Now we're gonna do the fly. So grab the fly. Go down a layer. Add a layer and then drag it under the layer we were just on. Size it down a little bit, but don't size it down too much to where the quality is really shitty looking. Then we're going to grab from here, highlight from here, grab it, and drag it over. So like that. And we're going to erase any excess. You could do that beforehand, dragging it over, up to you, it does not matter. Just going to erase it. And now, because the fly goes down a little too low, and we don't want that, we're just going to grab the lower end, select it, and drag it up some. So it will be a little bit smaller. Now you can merge those layers together. Now for the final part of this section, we're just gonna grab this that holds a belt. We might not put a belt on it, but you're just gonna want it for the extra detail. And then put it somewhere around here. I'd say put it like this, how I have it now, and then delete the top. So like that, and then you can just copy it over. For the tutorial, I'm gonna do that. If you want some extra variety and then not to be all the same, you can go back to your jeans and then copy this one, for example. But I'm just gonna keep it like that. And before you merge, copy this part and paste it over on this side and then merge it together. And then that's the top done. It's very simple, this part. Alright, now the next section. We're going to make a new layer and drag it underneath this part. This is just like the actual jean itself. Just copy from the top to the bottom. And there you go. Now drag it to this first section right here. Exactly how mine is. I can drag it a little bit more to the side. Now, for the sides, which is this one, and this one, and for this side, it's this one, and this one. For the sides, you're going to want to grab from the back, but not all the way up here. You're going to want to grab from, like, right down here somewheres for the sides. And just put it on the side like that. And I'll grab this side. And put it down there. So like that, that should be good. Now, grab the back side completely instead of just grabbing one section. Oh. Size it down to where it fits. So, like that. And then now, what we learned in the last video is what we're going to do. We're going to grab our clone tool. We're going to set the hardness to 0 and the brush size to 15. And we're just going to fade this. Make a smooth transition where the rankers are. Do that. Just transition it. Make it look smooth. Make it look like it's supposed to look like that. For this one, since it's so bright, we're going to grab from this side a little bit more. And then transition it like that. And boom. That's that side done. Now you can copy it over. Just like so. Just how I did. But there's going to be one thing that we're going to change, okay? We're going to grab from this side of the gene. The right side of the gene. Instead of the left. And we're going to put it over the front side on the right side. So like right there is good. Just so we have some variety. If you don't want to, you don't have to do that necessarily, but it will just make it look like it, the gene isn't a complete copy. It's like that. That's good. Now that we have that, we can copy. Well, merge it down, sorry. And your gene should look like this so far. If it does not, you have a serious problem and probably want to go back and fix it. Now, for the pockets, we're going to do this as a separate section as well. For the pockets, grab from the right side, because usually always on the left side, there's going to be this little pocket part right here. So always grab from the right side, right? And then paste it in. Make sure it's pretty... pretty big but not too big, so like some like that, right? And erase any excess. Don't erase this part though right here. You'll see why in a second. It just kind of looks better. We're gonna copy it over on this side. This time though, on the right side, I mean the left side, erase this part, because now we're gonna add the pocket in. So go up a layer, drag it down, paste the pocket in, and put it like right there. And you're good. And now erase excess on the pocket. So it should look like that. Now you can merge it down and merge it all the way down. There we go. That's pockets done. And now for extra detail, for the little sides on the pants. This right here, we're gonna add this part. So just copy it, go up a layer, copy it in, paste it down, put it a little straight but not too straight. Yeah, I mean it doesn't really matter because we're gonna change it in a second here. Make like kind of like a smooth transition. And now since it's too much to the right, we're gonna move it closer to the pocket, because if you look on these jeans, like the actual gene, the pocket connects to this line. So what we want is to put the line close to the pocket. So like that. So it looks like it connects. And make sure it doesn't go over this part, because it doesn't go over it on the actual gene. So there you go. You can just Copy and paste it over. Just like so. And this is where we're going to make it a little bit more different and not completely the same. We're going to go to Tools and then Liquify. And we're just going to keep it at like size 50 and just make some wiggles in this part right here. Just like that. And kind of like, oh, hold on. Anyways, just keep doing the wiggles, kind of like wavy. It's like that. Should look something like that, at least. And you can just merge that down. Now, for this part right here, you can't see it on this pair of jeans at least, but these connect to the line as well alongside with the pockets. These parts right here. So to mimic that, sometimes your jean will either have this part or this line right here will be flat as well. But since that's not the case, we're going to copy from this part real quick. And we're going to paste it in, add a new layer, of course. Put it sideways. Make it pretty long. Put it pretty close to the top of the jean as well. Try and straighten it out. And then now, just remove any excess. There we go. Since that doesn't look too natural, I'm going to put an effect on it real quick. And what I'll put on it is drop shadow. And kind of like that. And I will also do this. Not everyone will need to do this. It just doesn't, for my jeans at least, it doesn't look like it's supposed to necessarily be there. So that's what I'm going to do. And then I'll just copy it to the other side. And you can merge that down as well. You don't have to move those ones around. Now, really all that's left is a couple more details. So you can grab your pocket. Gonna want the pockets for sure. To make sure it's in the middle, you can remove this so you don't have to look at it. And kind of just put it in the middle of your jean. Like so. We can put it a little lower. So like that. Remove any excess, of course. Look as smooth as possible. There we go. And we can just edit that to the other side. There we go. And to make them a little bit more different, we're just going to go to the tools, liquify again, and just smudge them around a little bit so they look somewhat different. There we go. And then you can put that layer down. And last thing we're going to do is we're going to go to the bottom of the pants right here, and we're going to copy this part. Paste it up a layer. Again, make it pretty long. Do what I'm doing right here. Can't really explain it. Just cut off the little edges after rotating it to make it straight. And we're gonna cut off the bottom as well. Then copy and paste it over. Get rid of the excess. So like that. And I'm just gonna copy this part over. Now what you're gonna wanna do with this is go to your tools, liquify again. Put your size up to like 80, I'd say, and just kind of like curve exactly where I'm curving them. Pretty pretty high, but not too high. Kind of like that. Make sure you thicken them a little bit, like I'm doing right now. So like, that should be perfect. Now, since we lost a little bit of quality, I'm gonna go to highlights and shadows. I'm gonna increase the clarity somewhat and the radius. Sound like that should be good. Now, before we merge it down, we're gonna go to the full picture of the gene layer, this layer right here. We're gonna go to our eraser, put the hardness pretty high up, and erase. Just where I'm erasing, erase it right here. And before you also merge it as well, go back to this layer, add shadow, drop shadow, but instead put the angle to exactly 90 on the spot. If you can't get it there exactly, it can be a little bit off. It doesn't 100% matter. Put the distance pretty low, and something like that is good. Then you can merge it down. And now, all you have to do really now is make underwear. Oh, make underwear or something. Put them on and make shoes. But since that's not what this video is for, I'm just gonna grab shoes and underwear real quick. Cause yeah. So I'll just do these two. I'll add the underwear, add the shoes, and then I'll merge the layers down. And that's your pants done. Okay. Now this part is going to be about the hoodie. It's going to be similar to the shirt we made in the last video. Very similar, in fact, actually. So yeah, let's get started. First, you're going to want the front image of your hoodie. And you're going to want to copy something about like right here. Like, make sure it looks similar to what I'm copying. Bring it to your template, go up a layer, and paste it into the front torso bit. So, like that. Now, get ready. Right, these little lines right here, if you have them. You might not, based on what your picture looks like compared to mine. Mine did have them though, so I'm just gonna get rid of them real quick. If it's barely noticeable, then don't worry about it, you'll be good. So now I can remove these little bits that are popping off like that. And now go to the back of your hoodie, the image, copy a bit like right there. If the back of your hoodie is clear, of course. You might not have a bit of the back of your hoodie being clear, so if not, just find another part on the hoodie, like the sleeves maybe. So just put it there and grab it again and put it on this side. Okay, now for the top up here, I'm gonna go back here, grab from like right here, size it down and paste it to right about there. Now we're gonna grab the back, full bit of the back, so like that, and paste it down where it's supposed to go. Now, for this part, which I can't remember what this is called, but the little bit of fabric that's right here, we're gonna want to make sure the line is like straight. It's kind of like the jeans. You're just gonna want to make sure it's straight and nothing like interferes with it. So how I'm doing it right now, just do it like me. Make sure everything is transitioning well. I don't know why. Nothing, never mind. Like that. That looks a little odd, so I'll just do that. There we go. And that's this part of the hoodie done, the torso bit. So for the sleeves, all I'm gonna do is just copy from like right here to there, paste it down, paste it over, get rid of the access. It's like right there. Yep. And then merge it, transition, whatever. So like that. Clean it up a little bit, because there's like these little spots that you guys probably can't see, but I could see. Anyways, then we're just gonna copy and paste it over just like this. Instead of copying and pasting it over like the jeans like this, just do it like this. Then you can go right here, go as far as you can go down without touching these parts, and just copy and paste and move it up like that. Now that's like the foundation of your hoodie done. Now the hardest part about the hoodie, which isn't really hard if you just pay attention. So what we're gonna do is, if you have any background image, kind of like get rid of it. If not, it's fine too. You can get rid of it as we go. All right, now first thing, copy like right about here on the hoodie. Go up a layer, paste, and put that part that we just copied like somewhere's like this. Now go to your effects, liquify the size down a little bit, and now just rise this up like so, and now for this part, rise this part up so it kind of curves just like mine, the little shadowy bit, so it curves like that. Put this a little lower, so like that. It's gonna look a little odd, but it's fine since no one can really see this part too good. We'll just put our clarity on, clarity up a little bit, so like that. And that's good. Remove any excess now. So like this part right here, and this part, and you can erase some of the shadows a little bit if you don't want them so harsh. They look pretty weird if they're too black. So like that. Now before we merge it, we're gonna go to our drop shadow, and we're gonna do one on the side. So this shadow right here, you see, like right there. Okay, then we're gonna go back to our drop shadow after we hit confirm or okay. And we're gonna do it on this side as well. So that way we just have a shadow, right? Now we can merge that down, put our hardness all the way up on the eraser tool, and just add a neck hole. So like, something like that should work for you. Now for the rest of the hoodie, I'm gonna grab this portion up here, control C, up another layer, control V, and then rotate it this direction, the right direction. Rotate it right up until you're 180. And put it exactly here, so it lines up with this part. Now, we're going to want to zoom in real quick and then copy from like right there. Now, I'm going to go up a layer, copy it in, rotate it, size it down a little bit so it matches the ends, and then go to this layer. Since we haven't merged it yet, Control A, Control C, go back to the hood layer, this layer right here, and go to tools, liquify, and then right click on liquify and click this button from clipboard, and it should look like this. If it doesn't, then redo the steps, listen closely to what I did, okay? And all you're gonna wanna do is kinda just match it closer, really. Make sure it connects with the lines. It's like, that should be good. Something like that. Now you can merge down a layer and get rid of this part. And we're gonna wanna add drop shadow so it looks smoother. We can put the distance up a little bit and the shadow radius. Matter of fact, I'm gonna put the distance. All right, so like that. And that's the hood done. And that's basically the whole hoodie. We're just gonna add a little bit more extra details. So go to liquify, put the size to like 90, and then just put this up a little bit right at the front side. And for the sleeves, just go like how I'm doing it right now. Just like that. And boom. Then you can delete the access that's going off the template. And that's your hoodie done. Just like that. It's that simple. Alright, so if you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please drop a like. I really try and make these videos as often as I can, but you know, I'll be busy sometimes. So yeah, if you really enjoyed it, drop a like. It will show your appreciation, and I'll probably keep making these videos if you guys like them. So yeah, have a good day and goodbye.